Hello learners, another video of Tools and Techniques of Biology is here. The last video of this series we made on DNA isolation protocol. If you haven't watched it yet, please do, because today's video is extended part of extraction procedure of DNA. So you will get it easily. You have already guessed today's topic, that is gel electrophoresis. And there are several gel electrophoresis methods by which DNA, protein, RNA or other biomolecules could be separated or to be examined. In this video, our focus will be on these points. What is electrophoresis? Importance of electrophoresis? Principles of electrophoresis based on which the methods are developed? And for this class, we learn one method, that is agarose gel electrophoresis. So let's learn. First of all, dissect the term. Electro refers to the energy of electricity and phoresis from the Greek verb phoros, means to carry across. This gives us clues to direct definition of electrophoresis, that it is an analytical tool that allows biochemists to examine the differential movement of charged molecules in an electric field. A. Tesselius invented the technique in 1930. He performed experiments in free solution that were severely limited by the effects of diffusion and convection currents. This is also known as moving boundary electrophoresis, generally used for analysis, not for the fractional of complex mixture. While we use in modern lab polymerized gel like matrix, which is more stable as support medium. This technique is termed as zone electrophoresis, which is used for both analytical and preparative purposes. Gradually, we will get to know about it. Moving forward, let's understand what influence migration of biomolecules in the medium. I have used the term migration of biomolecules. So what is it? So the movement of charged molecules is called migration. Molecules migrate towards the opposite charge. A molecule with a negative charge, suppose DNA, will therefore pull together towards the positive end. Okay, first and foremost, the then charge and size, shape, chemical composition of the molecules to be separated, and then the rigid and maze-like matrix of the gel support, as I mentioned earlier, the polymerized gel, and the finally the applied electric field. Electrophoresis is relatively rapid, inexpensive and convenient technique, which is capable of analyzing and purifying many different types of biomolecules, but especially proteins and nucleic acids. It should be worthwhile to construct any biotechnical method that will lead science in progress. Similarly, electrophoresis has been useful for decades in pharmaceuticals as capillary electrophoresis, which provides extremely high resolution and is useful for analysis of both large and small molecules. In proteomics, using two-dimensional gel electrophoresis, this field expands rapidly. There are a few popular applications I should mention here. In separation of DNA fragments for DNA fingerprinting, to investigate crime scenes, to analyze results of polymerase chain reaction, to analyze genes associated with a particular illness, in DNA profiling for taxonomy study, to distinguish different species. In electrophoresis technique, this event in a medium subjected to an electric field is represented by this equation, V equal to EQ by F, where V is the velocity of the molecule, E is the electric field, and Q refers to the net charge on the molecule, and F represents as frictional coefficient, which depends on the mass and shape of the molecule. It's clear the charged particle moves at a velocity that depends directly on the electric field and charge, but inversely on a counteracting force generated by the viscous drag. The applied voltage, that is E, in equation is usually held constant. Therefore, charged molecule depends only on the ratio Q by F. For molecules of similar conformation, as a collection of linear DNA fragments or spherical proteins, the F, the frictional coefficient, varies with size but not shape. Now the only remaining variable are the charge and the mass dependence of F. Meaning, under such conditions, molecules migrate in an electric field at a rate proportional to their charge to mass ratio. The movement of charged particles in an electric field is often defined in terms of mobility, or mu. That is the velocity per unit of electric field. Here it is. This equation could be modified using by the first equation. In theory, if the net charge Q on a molecule is known, it should be possible to measure the F and obtain information about the hydrodynamic size and shape of that molecule by investigating its mobility in an electric field. Another aspect, if two molecules have the same mass and a shape, the one with greater net charge will move faster towards an electrode. The standard method used to characterize RNA and DNA in the range of 200 to 50,000 base pairs in electrophoresis with agarose as the support medium. So materials required here are agarose solution. Agarose is a product extracted from seaweed, which is a linear polymer of galactopyranose derivatives. Ethidium bromide, a fluorescent dye used for staining nucleic acids. Electrophoresis buffer, which is usually trace acetate EDTA or trace borate EDTA. DNA samples, which are of DNAs of known size, which are typically generated by restriction enzyme digestion of a plasmid or bacteriophage DNA of known sequence. And DNA ladders. DNA ladders are DNA markers. A DNA marker is loaded into the first well or slots made by comb of the gel. The fragment in the marker are of a known length, so can be used to help approximate the size of fragments in the samples. There are few more equipments and supplies are necessary. An electrophoresis chamber and power supply. Gel casting trays, which are available in a variety of size and composed of UV transparent plastic. Sample combs around which molten agarose is poured to form sample wells in the gel. Loading buffer, which contains something dense as glycerol to allow the sample to fall into the sample wells, and one or two tracking dyes, which migrate in the gel and allows visual monitoring or how further electrophoresis has proceeded. The dye, usually bromophenol blue, is added to the sample of DNA to increase the viscosity of the sample, which will prevent it from floating out of the wells, and so that the migration of the sample through the gel can be seen. And transilluminator, an ultraviolet light box, so which is used to visualize ethidium bromide stained DNA in gels. It is advised to wear protective eyewear when observing the DNA on a transilluminator to prevent the damage to the eyes. Okay, now gels are prepared by dissolving agarose in warm electrophoresis buffer. For this, we take 2 ml of TAE stock solution in an Erlenmeyer flask or conical flask and make the volume to 100 ml by adding 98 ml of distilled water. The working solution is 40 millimole trace acetate per 1 millimole EDTA. Now you should remember, it is important to use the same batch of electrophoresis buffer in both the electrophoresis tank and the gel preparation. Here, I want to share a thought. This terms stock solution, 50x concentrated stock solution, how to prepare stock solution, what is working solution, this knowledge should be clear, which you will find in various lab-based methods. And I will make separate video on these concepts, otherwise this video could be longer. So, moving forward, now we have to prepare a solution of agarose in electrophoresis buffer at an appropriate concentration. The mobility of nucleic acids in agarose gel is influenced by this and molecular size. The molecular conformation of the nucleic acid is there too. So the agarose concentration of 0.3 to 2.0% are most effective for nucleic acid separation. This is a chart where it's clear is the effective range of separation of DNA by agarose. Okay, now the conical flask should be loosely plugged. Heat the slurry in a boiling water bath until the agarose dissolved at 55 degrees centigrade. When the molten gel has cooled, add 0.5 microgram per milliliter of ethidium bromide and mixing the gel solution by gentle swirling. Here you need to know a fact of dye usage. Nucleic acids may also be stained with the new fluorescent SYBR dyes, which are less toxic than the mutagenic ethidium bromide. While the agarose solution is cooling, choose an appropriate comb for forming the sample slots or wills in the gel. And pour the warm agarose solution into the mold and allow the gel to set completely, like 30 to 45 minutes at room temperature. Then pour a small amount of electrophoresis buffer on the top of the gel and carefully remove the comb. Pour off the electrophoresis buffer and mount the gel in electrophoresis tank. Now, adding enough electrophoresis buffer to cover the gel to a depth of across 1 millimeter. And next step is mixing the samples of DNA with 0.2 volumes of the desired 6x gel loading buffer. Slowly load the sample mixture into the slots of a submerged gel using a disposable micropipette or an automatic micropipette. Finally, closing the lid of the gel tank and attach the electric lid so that the DNA will migrate toward the positive anode that should be red lid. Here, you need to focus on the distance between the positive and negative electrodes. So, apply a voltage of 1 to 5 volt per centimeter. If electrodes are 10 centimeter apart, then run the gel at 50 volt. So it's fine to run the gel slower, but do not run it any faster. Above 5 volt per centimeter, the agarose may heat up and begin to melt with disastrous effect on your gel's resolution. Here another aspect you need to notice, if the leads have been attached correctly, bubbles should not be generated at the anode and cathode. At last, run the gel until bromophenol blue and xylene xylol have migrated an appropriate distance through the gel. Here is an interesting part. The presence of ethidium bromide allows the gel to be examined by UV illuminator at any stage during the process. Or after the whole process, you could place the gel directly under it and observe orange bands of DNA. Till now, we try to understand the preparation and performing the method. But what we are going to get out of it and its applications, how to read or interpret the results of DNA migrations, all these are yet to be discussed, and I'll be back soon with another video on these topics. Till then, stay with Paper Pen Biology. I strictly took guide from these two books and these websites. I suggest you to read books first and then expand your knowledge with helpful videos available. Please put a comment for any suggestions, questions. Feel free to subscribe for many more videos like this. Thank you for your patience.